In order to use this device effectively, I thought it would be more effective to use it connected to a mobile or PC rather than using it independently. So how I could use T-Glass better? The goal of this project is to transfer an image captured on macOS via BLE and display it on the T-Glass Prism display. Bluetooth low energy is the best option for connecting peripherals, and it is very easy to connect and can also transfer data. If you need to send streaming data continuously, the Wi-Fi option would be the best, but in this case, the target is to display a still shot image on the screen, not streaming data. This project requires two applications. One is a BLE client that runs on ESP32, and the other one is a BLE app that runs on macOS. The Mac application was created using Flutter. Flutter makes it very easy to create applications that support multiple operating systems, so I recommend giving a try. Let me show you how it works. The way it works is very intuitive. T-Glass is already ready. In this Flutter app, enter the target device name to start Bluetooth scanning. The connection is established. After that, press the Capture Region button and drag the part of the screen you want to capture. Press the Send button and then you can see your captured image on the T-Glass soon. You can see the image I sent now. The reason it looks flipped is because I'm looking at it from the outside of the glasses, not the inside. I will show you the screen again later. Another feature is that it supports the system tray function, so after pressing the capture button, if you drag, the image will be sent immediately. I think this could be used more effectively if a shortcut function was added. Now let's talk about the T-Glass screen. The actual visual resolution for this is 126x126. This is a very small resolution and can only display very small images. A higher resolution display is required, but this will probably be the main factor driving up the price. I hope the next version will come up with a higher resolution version at a reasonable price if they have a plan for this. So, in the Flutter app, the captured image is reduced to the corresponding size. At this time, the ratio of the image is maintained so that the image is not distorted. The BLE package used in the Flutter app does not support Windows, so to build for Windows, there is a separate BLE package for Windows. If we change to this and build, it can work in a Windows environment as well. The default package size that can be sent at once in BLE is 20 bytes each. By adjusting the MTU size, you can send a larger package at once so you can transmit large data faster. This is usually controlled by the server side, and this BLE package automatically allows the package size to be up to 215 bytes in my case. It seems that this entirely sets a different MTU size depending on the OS used. I think I need to follow up on this a bit more. As you can see, it's a very simple application. The source code can be found on my project GitHub, so please check it out if you need it. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.